Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, I will continue discussing leaving groups in SN1, SN2, E1, and E2 reactions. In part 1, we discussed the concept and effect of a leaving group in substitution and elimination reactions. In this video, we'll look at how to make OH, which is a bad leaving group, into a good leaving group by bribing it. Let's quickly review why we have to bribe the OH. If we have a molecule that has an OH group, and we turn OH into a leaving group, oxygen will grab the electrons that keep it connected to carbon, resulting in a positive charge on the carbon chain and a negative charge on the oxygen leaving group. However, because oxygen is a small, highly electronegative atom, it will not be happy with the negative charge, making it unstable and very reactive. An OH minus by itself will simply attack the positive charge on the carbon chain, reversing the reaction. If you want the OH group to leave and stay gone, you have to bribe it so that it is no longer highly concentrated with negative charge. One way to do this is to activate the leaving group using an acid catalyst. In other words, you want to bribe the oxygen with a positive hydrogen. I will simplify this as H+ and H2O, but you can also see this as HCl, HBr, or simply any acidic solution. Since oxygen is highly electronegative, even while it's attached to carbon, it will still reach out for that positive hydrogen. This results in an oxygen atom that has three bonds, one lone pair, and a formal charge of plus one. Since oxygen does not like having that positive charge, it will be a lot more likely to grab the electrons that connect it to the carbon chain, and therefore a lot more likely to break off. Now look at what happens as a result. In addition to the carbocation that forms, I also have a molecule composed of oxygen bound to two hydrogens, and this oxygen once again has two lone pairs of electrons, given that it took the electron pair that connected it to carbon. Now that oxygen has two bonds and two lone pairs, it is very stable given that it's a neutral molecule in solution. Because it's stable, it's happy and unreactive, and is a lot less likely to reach for that carbocation and attack. This is one way to make oxygen into a good leaving group. There are many large molecules that you can use to turn oxygen into a good leaving group. Two common ones that you'll see in your substitution and elimination reactions include methyl sulfonyl chloride and para-toluene sulfonyl chloride. If you're worried about these molecules being a mouthful, don't. We'll replace the methyl group with an R, and we'll replace this entire structure also with an R. Because the key focus here is the fact that we have an R group bound to a sulfur that is double bound to two oxygen atoms and single bound to a chlorine. Let's take a quick look at how the alcohol interacts with the sulfonyl chloride. Now, why did I show it so quickly? Because you don't have to know the mechanism. All you have to do is understand that the oxygen attacks the sulfur and ultimately replaces the chlorine. In fact, if you go back to these molecules, not only don't you have to know the structure, but you can actually shorten them. The methyl sulfonyl chloride will be MSCl, the para-toluene sulfonyl chloride will be TSCl, and you can show the simplified mechanism as follows. The oxygen reaches out and attacks the toluene sulfonyl chloride, and chlorine gets kicked out in the presence of a base called pyridine. Pyridine does remove the hydrogen, but we're not going to focus on that here. Instead, we'll just look at the fact that oxygen is now bound to the tosyl group, which you write as OTS, and that's it. Now, how is this a good leaving group, and why did we go through all this trouble? Let's understand what's actually going on here. When oxygen is bound to the sulfonyl group, the oxygen is now connected to a very large network of atoms. When oxygen takes the electrons from carbon to break off as a leaving group, it's not just that single oxygen holding the negative charge. Oxygen can use its electrons to form a pi bond between itself and sulfur, kicking out the pi bond from the top sulfur oxygen, or it can do the same thing and kick out the pi bond from the bottom sulfur to oxygen. That means that instead of one oxygen carrying the charge, we actually have three oxygens each carrying a third of that negative charge, making this negative group so stable that it's a decent leaving group. There are other groups that have similar reactions, such as PBr3 and SOCl2, but that's usually covered when you study alcohol reactions. But for substitution and elimination reactions, be sure that you don't miss my upcoming videos, where I break down and then compare SN1, SN2, E1, and E2 reactions. You can catch the entire series on my website, leahforsci.com/substitution-elimination.
Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, download my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry, using the link below, or visit leahforsci.com/orgosecrets. That's O-R-G-O secrets. For information regarding online tutoring, visit leahforsci.com/orgotutor. That's O-R-G-O tutor. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and even share it with a friend or two. If you have any questions regarding this video, leave a comment below or contact me through my Facebook page at facebook.com/leahforsci. There will be many related videos posted over the course of the semester, so go ahead and click the subscribe button to ensure that you don't miss out.